effect. In an After Effect, first of all, just click on this project window. A browser window will open and import this image. Now I have downloaded this image from the internet. Now what you have to do is right click here, new composition, and just select the size of the composition, 1280 by 720. It's like a standard size in After Effects for creating a basic compositions. Now check the background color, it will be black, and then okay. Now you have got a nice composition of this size. What you have to do, you have to just select this image, drag it onto the timeline, and you have got this image onto this composition. Now right click on it, go to this transform and just click on fit to comp. Now your image has taken the size of this composition. Now again right click on this timeline, go to new and just select a solid kind of an image or solid, it's just a solid. Just click on the solid blank footage. Now it's again have a size of 1280 by 720 with a black color, and just click on OK. You have got a nice image as a black image. Now right click on this image again, go to this effect. Now you have an option of simulation, and we have different kind of particle system. Just select this particle world. Now with this particle world, you have got a nice particle world kind of a world system, and when you just drag it and play it, you have got a nice particle flowing from the emitter. Now what you have to do, you have to just close all this horizontal line and this grid option. Go to this grid and guide, just and uncheck this grid, horizon and this axis box. This option is called axis box, just off it. Now look at your particle system. Now if your particle system is not being visible properly, just what you have to do, you have to just darken your back environment. For that, just right click on this image again, go to this effect. You have an option of color correction, and go to this exposure settings. When you click on this exposure settings, just decrease the exposure value and the gamma value of this image will become a little dark. Now your particle will become more highlighted and more prominent. What you have to do, just again go to this particle settings, off this grid and guide settings, go to this physics, and we have an option of like animation style called explosive. These are called predefined and pre-settings. Okay, it's like an explosion kind of a particle system. You have to just replace it with a fire. Now fire will give you a nice fire kind of an effect. The particle is moving upward in up direction as fire goes. Now just see this like red icon. Is this red is called an emitter. You have to just select this emitter and put it onto wherever you want this particle to be emit outside. After this, just go to this particle settings, and we have an option of particle type. Change this particle type to tripolygons. Then you will see that the number of particles and in the form of like triangular polygons. Now again go to this up direction. We have a very good option called birth rate and longevity. What is birth rate? Birth rate decide how much number of particle will emit in every seconds. Now you have to increase this number of particles. See, the density of the particle increases. Now after this, longevity will control the life of the particle, that how much particle will live. Okay, see, this the particle is going to be dying after this number of values. Okay, now this is my final value of this particle to be dying in this area. Now again I want this particle to be a bit small. For that, again you have one more settings called particle birth size and death size. Just reduce the size of this birth and the death also. And again, what you have got, you have got a particle density of the particle. You have to increase the density of the particle. Again you have to just increase the birth rate, increase it as much as you can. After that, when you play this particle system, what you will find, that particle is moving in the upward direction with a very high speed. To like control this speed, don't decrease this velocity option. You have to just increase the resistance. Resistance is an option which make this particle or does not allow this particle to move in the upward direction. Now the particle is moving in a very limited area. Now what you have to do, you have to just decrease a bit of the velocity like this, and when you play, you have got the movement of the particle like this. Now just increase the size of this longevity like this. Particle will move in upward direction like this. After this, what you can do, just change the color of this particle, make it more yellow and more red or a bit of an orange like this. Okay, in this way you got a particle looks like a fire. And after that just right click here, go to this effect option, again go to this blur and just click on an option called vector blur. Okay, when you click on this vector blur, so you have an option to change the particle looks like this. Okay, change the type to constant length or the perpendicular or like directional center or different kind of option. I am just changing this to perpendicular and just increasing the amount of this particle. Okay, now particle looks a bit more look like this. See this. Okay, now finally what I have to do, I have to just again right click on this particle, go to this effect. We have one more good option which is called rough edges. Go to the stylish. We have an option of like rough edges. What it can do for me, it can just roughen the edges of this particle. But for that we have to just change this type to like either it could be a rusty or it could be a spiky. Both are good for me. Just change it to like rusty and spiky, or just change it to like spiky. And just border size, you can just check it. Even reduce the scaling option. Fractal influence. Edge sharpness. Now just have a look on this particle. It's look like this. Now you have seen this, the edge is not an animating. Otherwise all the things are going to be animated. Now what you have to do, you have to just animate this effect. Now we have two options. First is evolution, which can animate this for me. Again offset will do an animation for me. Now just check how much an animation you required for this composition. So for that, just click on this evolution option, and just for the 8 seconds you can just change increase the amount of this evolution up to the 4 loops. Now when you play it, again change it like 20. Now we have an option of offset. What you have to do, you have to just click offset on this side, click here and go to the upward direction. Just move it to like in upward direction like this. Okay, so now offset make this particle to move in the upward direction. Cool, that's great. So I'm getting a very nice particle kind of an effect with the fire itself. Now one more thing I have to do is that we have an option of like distort, we have an option of like turbulence displays. When you click here, you have got a nice turbulence kind of an effect. And turbulent hai, bulge, twist, turbulent smoother, we have different option. Click on this turbulent. Size, just reduce the size of this turbulent a bit. Increase the amount of this turbulent. And even we have this pinning option and resize layer option. We have all the other option. We can just make it a pin on the bottom layer. Increase the complexity to make it more rough like this. And just animate this evolution parameter again. Click here, go to this 8 second and just increase this value to again 20. So when you play it, you've got a very good or very like a turbulence. We have got a very harsh kind of a turbulence. So what you can do, you can just increase the amount of this turbulence effect. Okay. Now this is my fire effect. Got it? Again, we have lots of settings like turbulence. I did turbulence, I did rough edges, I did CC vector blur in it. Now again go to the particle, just reduce the birth rate of the particle to make it a bit light, like this. Increase the velocity or just decrease the resistance area. Go to this vector blur parameter and just rigid this smoothness area. Now you have got a fire with a different effect like this. Okay, reduce the size of this particle system and just increase the birth rate a bit. Okay, so in this way you've got a nice fire kind of an effect in it. Finally, when you did all these things, just right click on this, again go to the stylize and we have an option glow. You can make it a bit glow. Before that, go to the particle system and just change this color to more orange. Okay, now when you are into the particle system, like a glow parameter, you can just glow threshold. You can control the glow threshold, glow radius, glow size area. We have an option of composite behind, on top, behind would be great. We have different kind of like operations. Color, if you want original color, we can take the original color, or we can go to this AB color. This is called AB color. You can just change this A color to orange and B color to completely red. Then what, orange to red kind of an effect. Or if you take original color, then original color will glow a bit like this. Okay. Now what you have to do, you have to just Control D, duplicate this. Duplicate it. And just select the first one. And use this, there's an option of like blending modes. Just make it a height for temporarily hide the upper layer. Go to this lower layer, change this mode to like add. You can add it with the background so that it will become a part of the background. Now go to this upper layer, select this layer, go to the transparency and just remove this transparency a bit so that you can get an effect of the upper layer and the lower layer both like this. Now in this way you can get nice particle effect in your composition. Okay, make a copy of this layer, that is your first background layer. Again Control D, you have got a nice second layer. Go to this effect, color correction. We have an option of hue saturation. In hue saturation, just click on this colorize option. And after that, just colorize this hue to a yellowish kind of a color like this and increase the saturation. Okay, now make a selection of this layer to this environment. And again, go to this mask settings. And in this mask setting, you have to just increase this feather area. This feather area will make it a bit orange kind of an effect. Now just see this, you have an orangish kind of an effect in this area, and normal area would look like this. Again, click here, press T, go to this opacity settings. When you just make this opacity as 0, there's no orangish effect. So go to this first frame. I didn't have any kind of an orangish effect, but when the fire goes up, I required this orangish kind of a warm effect into this composition. So composition look like this. Now when I play, let's play and get an effect of like fire into your scene. So okay, now I think you got satisfied with the effect of the fire with the minimalistic like of settings I have used in After Effects. So that's it for today. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot. Bye.